Greetings. My name is Stasia Bliss, and I'm here to introduce the concept of life force management. So we are at a very exciting time on the planet and in the lives of the collective, in that what used to be just an individual experience of spiritual maturation, documented throughout history, and especially in Asian countries, as an awakening, spiritual awakening, kundalini experience, ascension, the aha moment, the God moment, seeing God, seeing higher powers. These have been documented, these experiences, by individuals over time, and we have record of these things. But what is very special about this time that we are living in is we are in what could be called a collective ascension. So the ascension of planet Earth is an opportunity where higher frequencies, higher accessibility, more accessibility to the force of our life, life force energy, which always surrounds us, but we're not always able to access it in its larger sense, because we're individuated. So in our individuated forms, we've sort of had to dull down or close the valves to this life force energy just so we could handle being in these bodies. So we go through a process when we're born where we're still very much plugged in. And you could think of this system as like an electrical plug, and that life force energy is very much like electricity, or the energy of the cosmos, the energy of life, that which causes life. So it's that energy which brings life into our bodies, channels into us much like a plug plugs into a wall. And you have an outlet, and maybe you have some power converters to convert the voltage so it doesn't blow up the plugs or blow up the power strips and so forth, and appliances and whatnot. So in our bodies, we have a similar system. This system is how we regulate this life force energy in our body, and it's largely done automatically, much like many of our systems run, parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system, our heart beats automatically, our breath is automatic. All of our organ systems are automatic. But as we begin to awaken, as higher frequencies become available to us, as they are right now on planet Earth, we get a jolt, if you will. We receive more of this energy. And this can happen to us at various times in our life. It can happen in stages. It usually does happen as sometimes a burst or a jolting or a sort of like a surprise, aha, awakening moment, maybe where you see things really clearly and you see life bigger than you ever have seen it before. And then you don't really know what to do with it. Then you're not really sure how to process or integrate that. So that would be an initial kundalini awakening or spiritual awakening, awakening to higher frequencies that are able to happen in your body. So it's like all the valves for this energy, which are called chakras, and they lie along the spinal cord. The spinal cord is your main channel for accessing this energy. And the main nerve in the body is the vagus nerve. The vagus nerve is the longest nerve in the body. It runs the length of your spine and it touches into all the organs. So when we get this jolt of life force energy, it's like our consciousness is giving us access, a glimpse of a bigger picture, a bigger awareness. We maybe suddenly see our life from a larger vantage point, and then we may feel a little confused, or we may feel inspired, or we may feel like, what have I been doing all this time, when there's really like this bigger picture. So this is an initial awakening. This life force energy, life is kind, I feel, and it gives us these visions, this is how it could be, this inspired moment. That makes sense. And then the energy has to integrate. It has to come in and it has to work with all the organs and glands and nervous systems so that we can handle that much energy all the time. So after that initial moment, we might feel tired. We might feel exhausted. Our nerves might feel frazzled. because in order to handle more life force energy, the physical body has to adapt. It has to actually upgrade its system just like a computer would to carry like a different program. So like if you have an Apple phone and it wants certain programs right now that are running, but you don't have 13.0 or higher, you can't download that program, right? You can't access certain applications because your phone isn't wired for that much information or that information. So the body is similar in the way that our regulator valves, our chakras, are dialed to a certain frequency. A certain amount of life force is coming through at any given time. And each valve correlates with an area of our life, an area of consciousness, if you will. The root chakra at the base of our spine is dialed into all things physical, all things primal, instinctive, survival mechanisms, abundance versus poverty, home, shelter, clothing, basic needs being met. So when that is dialed down to a low flow, so it's tight, you could say, the iris is tight, then only a little bit of life force is coming in there and you're not able to access the full potentiality of feeling like you're always taken care of and your home is everywhere. And you know, some people do feel that way and you wonder if you don't, how they can feel that way. And it's because their chakra, their valve for consciousness in the first chakra has been dilated to receive more and they are able to handle that. They have integrated that frequency. And then you have various other ones, right? Like your throat chakra is going to dictate your ability to communicate information. The ability to ask for what you want, speak your truth, and process the information that's told to you. And do you take that in as something sweet? Are you able to take the nectar out of what you receive? Or does it come in as poison to you? That's all governed by this throat valve, throat chakra. And of course, you have many others that are doing this. So right now, as I mentioned, we're in a collective awakening. Life force energy is more available to the planet and to each one of us. So how do we work with that? How do we manage that energy? How do we, you know, take it into our body and not have a terrible time with it, not experience psychosis or, you know, have it be an overload to our system, because sometimes it can feel like that. And there are various ways, which I will be discussing in this video and in other videos, about how we manage this. And it's good to take it a step at a time, good to take it piece by piece, because there is a lot of information there. And if we try to do too much, too fast, it can be overwhelming, and then we can't integrate fast enough. So it's good to understand, first of all, just the system itself and what's happening. Okay, we're getting access to higher frequencies. The valves maybe have been more closed off for many of us, and the opportunity is for them to open more. So when they open more and we can receive greater amounts of life force energy, it's good to know what happens when that occurs. The first thing, or one of the first things that happens, is a cleansing or a purification of that chakra, or that valve. It's like the lens is getting polished. And all the belief structures that were on that valve, or all of the makeup of that part of your consciousness, goes through like a flushing out. It goes through a purification process, a purging. It's just like if you're going to move into a new house and you're like, I need to clean this house. So consciousness is coming in and it's going, okay, I'm going to use this vessel for more consciousness, but it's kind of a little cluttered in here. So I'm gonna go into each place, each chakra, and I'm gonna polish it out. So it's very much like the process of cleaning your house, decluttering, feng shuiing your home, and why those things are helpful in managing your energy. That's outside work that affects the inner work. But also inner work affects the outer work. So we can do various yoga practices, Bandha locks and sun salutations and toning and so forth that help these chakras to purify themselves, breathing practices, meditation, We can also do purifying practices, such as outlined in yogic texts that are called shatkarmas, which are ways to purify the chakras, like candle gazing, or like neti pot, or like, again, some breathing techniques. There's various practices, which I will also be outlining in various videos, to help this purification process. But it's good to know that purification happens, because whatever was in there is going to come up and show itself before it's gone, before it upgrades, before you get the initiation. So this is where it gets tricky, because this is where, if we are not being the observer of the experience, in other words, if we don't know what's happening, if we're clueless to this awakening process, we don't know what an upgrade in our life force energy means, then we can get stuck in a loop, a karmic loop, if you will, a reincarnation loop that doesn't have to include dying. It just means your pattern is looping. And I know you know what this means when something happens and you think you've gotten over it, but then it happens again, and then you try to move on for it, and then it happens again. So what happens is that you are given the opportunity to pass this initiation every time the cycle reappears. But the only way you can pass it is if you are the observer mind. So that would mean having an open third eye and seeing what's happening and being aware, oh, this is a cleansing of my old reality. That's what's happening. Just being the observer, as we know in quantum physics, completely changes the reality. So instead of looping, because the emotion of, oh my gosh, this is happening again, why is this happening to me? Ah, and like getting back into the emotion of it causes the looping. It's the feedback that is saying, oh, I'm still working on this. I'm still working on this. I'm still working on this. I have emotions tied to this and I'm still working on it. So if we want to get off that hamster wheel, then we've got to cultivate an observer mind. And that is one of the main practices, one of the most important practices in working with life force management. And again, there's various articles and videos on that, such as Tratak, candle gazing, Shambhavi mudra, breathing in and out of the forehead, things like this. So after we are able to witness the cleansing, then we go to the next level. It's like that was able to dilate, that valve was able to dilate, and now we're working with a new frequency, a higher frequency. And now it's sort of like a test run, if you can stay in the awareness of the higher frequency. And of course, what also happens is a biological cleanse. There's actually a physical hormonal shift that happens when we expand our consciousness. And so old neurons and synapses associated with your old beliefs have to be released into your bloodstream and be discarded. So with this comes, could be feelings of depression, could be feelings of anxiety, could be sadness, sorrow, things like you feel like you're in it again, even though you're like, wait, I thought I had made the shift, but I'm still sad and depressed. I'm still in the old cycle. What's wrong with me? But if you know, oh, this is part of the process, then you're being observer mind and you can allow it to pass. You can allow the process. So important. So in these videos, I want to share with you simple techniques. How do we get through a feeling of scarcity consciousness? What are the life management techniques we can use for not feeling self-love, for not feeling like our voice is being heard, for processing any wounds coming up in our family line, for any of the things that might be coming up for you, including what's going on in the world? How do we do this? And then how do we also do this in relationship so that we're able to manage our energy in relationship? That's another part of life force management. So I'm excited to get a little bit deeper into this than has been available from me before. This is something that's been a longtime passion of mine for many, many years, several decades actually, and I'm really grateful to have the opportunity and the impetus to share this with you now. Many have been asking, and I feel like the time is right. So if you have questions, please let me know, either in the boxes below or send me an email, stasiabliss@gmail.com. Thank you so much, and more soon.